Welcome you all to today's modular classroom. Today we are going to see about Google Slides. So what is a Google Slide? It is nothing but really a presentation software with a huge number of features within it. So how to enter into this Google Slides? There are two methods. First, you can go to your drive directly and you can give new Google Slides. It will give you to the take you to the new slides. A new slide can be created with this Google Slide. Then other method is you can directly go to slide.google.com slides. You can go to, this is the second method where you have to enter slides.google.com. So once you enter this, it will also take you to create a new slide. From here you can give a start a new presentation and click the plus button for the blank presentation. This will also open you a new presentation. So with this presentation, Google Slides, you can develop a presentation where you can produce a presentation to a huge number of audience or even to the students, and you can produce this presentation to the classroom, and you can present with this Google Slides. So first we can start with one presentation. So with this presentation, first you have to name the slide this is going to reside in your drive. So already we know all these G Suite platforms are lying only in your drive. So this is an untitled presentation and you can type the name. So I can give my presentation. So this slide will hold the name my presentation and it will get saved in the your Google Drive. So I have entered the name. Next is you can do all kind of features. So first time you can add any number of slides. So there are three methods to add a new slide. So first method is you can press this plus button, so it will add you the new slide. See, now the new slide will be added. The second slide is added. The second method is this button, which is a drop down arrow button. If you click this drop down arrow button, also a new slide is created, but with the selected layout. You can select what is the layout. So if you give this button, this new layout is being created. So the other method is you can go to the slide menu and you can give new slides. So in these three ways you can add new slides to the presentation, and all the basic operations, basic editing operations you can do. For example, I am giving this recent trends. This is my title I am entering. Recent trends in information technology. So this is my title. So you can edit by using all the basic editing operations, whatever operations you want, you can do. So you can give the colors. If you go to the format option, you can give all the bold option. It is, see, you can see the difference, and you can align line spacing and borders and lines. You can give the border color. Everything you can, every operations you can give, and other is you can give the color, you can give any type of colors. So now I have added a new color also. So all the editing operations can be given. Then next what you can do is with this, you can add, there are many types of themes available. When you see at the right side, there are a lot of themes. You can click any themes you want. Whatever theme we want, we can select. And all type of whatever theme we want, we can add. See, I have and also you can import theme. So the themes can be selected from the right side. And another important feature is if you created a slide but you want to skip a slide, you can go right click any particular slide and you can give the skip slide, so that particular slide can be will not be visible while you do your presentation to the audience. Then another is you can go and insert image, text box, audio, video, any types of shapes, whatever shapes you want, you can add. You can add a circle, whatever shapes, and you can fill the shapes. Any shapes can be inserted. And you can insert, the other important feature is you can insert charts, diagrams from the sheets or the bar charts, whatever charts we want, we can add. And any other important feature that is not available in any other presentation software is when you go to the video, you can insert the YouTube video directly. If you mention the URL, for example, I'm searching a particular YouTube video, Modular Classroom is our YouTube channel name. And I'm searching for the quiz assignment. So that particular YouTube content will be searched. See, it is now appears. You can select this. That particular YouTube video will be selected. And with this video, you can, for example, this video will be viewed for 9 to 10 minutes. Means you can give the start and end time. So if you don't want to fill the whole video, you can give just 2 minutes to some 5 minutes. So you can that particular, see now the, you can feel the difference. So it takes you, this video takes to the second minute. If you go to the presentation's time, only the second minute, from second minute it can be viewed. So this is a very important feature that the other presentation software doesn't hold. Then the author feedback, when you go, if you want to present this, you can go to the present button. It will take you to the presentations thing. See, you can see that YouTube video by pressing the play. So we can see that view is getting played. So that particular video can be played. And other important feature is you can go to the presenter view. And two other important features given in this are author feedback and timer. See, we can see the timer. You can adjust the time seconds. If you want to present a particular slide for 30 minutes or 15 seconds or 2 seconds, you can adjust by giving the timer. And the other one is you can also give the speaker notes. And the other important feature is audience tools, where you can get the audience feedback. Audience feedback can be presented during your presentation. If you just accepting question, if you enabled, it is enough. So slidesapp.google, the question will appear here. So you can give the question and you can save it. So that it will take you to the new question session. So that when you go for a presentation to a huge number of audience, it will help you to get the type of questions or feedbacks from that particular kind of audience. And after that, you have to, from this presenter view, I'm exiting. From here, we can present or publish in two ways again. You can go to present. You can, near the present, you can share. If you share, it will give you the edit mode. So you can copy the link, go to the new tab, press Control V. And you can change this edit to present. This edit can be changed to the present mode so that you can see only, it will take you directly to the present view. So edit view cannot be given because it is saved in your own drive. So whatever we want to share with others, we just want to change this edit to the present mode. And another one is directly we can publish. The next method is you can go here, file, and you can make it as publish. So you can make an email as attachment. And here you can find publish to the web. You can take this link, publish. So here also you can adjust start slides and restart the slideshow after the last slide. These options we can enable. And you can publish. If you want to publish, we can, if you give S, it will give you the link. You can copy this link and you can publish to the web. So in this two method, you can publish to the presenter view either through the edit or to the. So here also we can start presenting. In this two method, you can publish this your presentation to the audience. So this, there are a lot of editing options and transitions options. There are a lot of transition options. Here we can give dissolve, fade for each slide. Animations can be given. So with this huge number of features, Google Slides helps every presenter to go for a presentation to the audience.